Good evening and welcome to the Village of Romeoville's workshop meeting this Monday, June 17th, 2013 at 6:04 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmiter? Trustee Chavez?
Here.
Trustee Clancy?
Here.
Trustee Richards? Trustee McLevitt?
Here.
Trustee Griffin?
Here.
Mayor Noak?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Very good. Trustee McLevitt, will you lead us in the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Great. The first thing we have on the agenda tonight is Resolution 131677, resolution to waive the bid process, enter into a contract with Wick Building Systems, Inc. for the purchase of 151 by 112 steel-sided building. Dan Brown-Barrett, please.
Thank you, Mayor. Within the budget, we were actually going to build two buildings, but looking at the cost, we were able to go with the same square footage and save about $8,000 if we just combine everything in the one building. We're looking to waive the bid process and go with Wick. They've been building our buildings for the last 12 years, so we know what to expect from them. When we first started this process, we did go out to bid, and they were the lowest, most responsive bidder at the time. So we know what to expect out of them. They know what to expect out of us. We have $100,000 budgeted. This building is almost a 122 in discussions with Village Manager Golden. We have about $200,000 in savings in the shooting range in phase two project. So he says move forward with this and bring it to the board and see what you guys think about moving forward with this last building.
Very good. Questions, comments? Trustee McLevitt, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I know we discussed this in the budget process. Could you remind me, though, the purpose of the building, what you'll be utilizing it for, why we need it?
Sure. This is going to be for water and wastewater. We've got some equipment that's sitting outside currently that we'd like to get inside. In addition, we're purchasing that additional stormwater pump, sanitary sewer pump. The biggest part of this need for this building is we're starting to do our large pump repairs in-house. We've been sending the guys to school and stuff, and so rather than contract that out, we can save some money, and these guys need an area to rebuild up to 60 horsepower pumps. So they're fairly large, so we want to set up an area for them, and we'll do this stuff in-house.
Great. So we're saving money by doing things in-house, and all the way around it ends up being a good project for us.
Absolutely.
Great. Thank you.
Yeah, very good point. Long-term investment to get better utilization over a period of time. Anyone else?
No, I'm good.
Nope. Okay, looking good. Very good. Thank you very much. Next, we have Resolution 131676, resolution waiving the bids and awarding a contract to Lumina Inc. for July 3rd and Romeo Fest fireworks displays. Kelly Razor, please.
Thank you, Mayor. As you can tell, summer is upon us, and it's that time of year. I am requesting and asking the board to enter into a contract with Lumina for the 2013 fireworks show for Independence Day celebration, July 3rd, and Romeo Fest, the two shows that we have. The cost for the fireworks for July 3rd is $17,000, August 2nd is $8,500, and August 4th is $8,500, and it's the same price as 2012, and we've worked with Lumina for over 20 years.
They've always done an excellent job, giving us a very good price. Questions, comments? Nope.
Can't wait.
Great job. Well, I'm sure everybody will be excited. And again, two shows at Romeo Fest.
Thank you. Very key,
just so everybody knows. And July 3rd. So anyway, so everyone remembers. If there's no other questions or comments, we'll move on to Ordinance 131048, Ordinance amending the designating ordinance of the Village of Romeoville in connection with the Des Plaines River Valley Enterprise Zone, and I'm sure she's going to take the next one at the same time. Ordinance 131047, ordinance approving the authorizing the execution of an amendment to the Des Plaines River Valley Enterprise Zone Intergovernmental Agreement. Don Caldwell, please.
Thank you, Your Honor. As you know, Romeoville is part of the Enterprise Zone. June 30th, that Enterprise Zone will expire. The General Assembly has passed legislation that allows each zone to apply for a 25-year extension. Right now, they're working on all the details of that extension and how you have to apply. The first step, though, they are allowing municipalities to enter an automatic three-year extension for that, which will go to July of 2016. Each individual community within the zone needs to approve this for our zone to go forward with the three-year extension.
Okay. Just so, again, this is more of a housekeeping thing than anything. State changed slightly its reauthorization language. When they did that, they required everybody to go through this housekeeping and endeavor. We're already moving forward on the application. This gives you a three-year automatic extension once you've indicated your interest in doing extension, and then you make an application, and then once they finalize the rules, which they haven't done or appointed the board for it yet, they'll tell us how the actual
the three-year extension is pretty automatic.
Yeah.
25-year is not. You have to right. They have to actually approve that for
yeah.
us.
So and that's still being finalized.
Correct.
On the rule side. All the legislative authority has been passed, but they still got to finalize all that process. Questions, comments?
Just for the residents' knowledge, this goes back, I think I read, to 1983 is when it was started.
Yeah, Romeoville joined, I want to say, in 89. It was started in 83, though.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Okay.
And it's Romeoville, Joliet, Lockport, Will County, and Rockdale.
Yes. I think you got everybody. Very good. Any other questions, comments? Very good. Go ahead. Trustee McClevitz, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. And again, just as far as the Enterprise Zone is another incentive we have to attract industry, business, whatever. So
absolutely.
That's why it's something that's good for us to have and why we do want to extend
it. It is. And the local benefits were actually taken out. It's more state benefits that are still in there.
Okay. Thank you.
Very good. Any other questions or comments? Hearing none, we will entertain a motion to adjourn.
So moved.
Motion second. By Trustee Clancy, second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, gotta get a roll call, please.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Great. We'll move by 1 minute. We'll move right into the workshop meeting, our regular meeting for the Village of Romeoville, this Monday, June 17th, 2013, at 6:12 p.m. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Palmiter? Trustee Chavez?
Here.
Trustee Clancy?
Here.
Trustee Richards? Trustee McClevitz?
Here.
Trustee Griffin?
Here.
Mayor Noak?
Here.
We have a quorum.
Very good. Trustee McClevitz, we lead some pledge.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Petitions from the public this evening. Petitions from the public. Any petitions from the public? Hearing none, we will move on for consent agenda. Do I have a motion for consent agenda?
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin.
Second.
Second by Trustee McClevitz. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Great. Within that consent agenda, we have approval of minutes June 5th, 2013 workshop meeting, approval of minutes June 5th, 2013 regular meeting, approval of bill Schedule A, approval of bill Schedule B, approval of bill Schedule C, Ordinance 131050, Ordinance on the Prevailing Wage Rates in Romeoville, and Resolution 131678, Resolution Accepting the Public Improvements at Paragon Business Park Building D2. Do I have a motion?
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Clancy, second by Trustee Griffin, even though he was slightly louder.
I know.
any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Clancy?
Yes.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Great. Mayor's report this evening. I want to thank everybody who attended the car show. It was a great event. Trustee Clancy, I think you were out there all day long. It really turned out pretty well, actually, even with the move. And I think everybody came out, had a fantastic time. I know my son had a lot of fun on that one motorcycle, especially. He had a good time going around, a lot of kids and family, so it was nice to see. I think everybody had a pretty good time. Want to congratulate John Gruling and the CED. I attended their eye-opener breakfast the other day with some of our staff, and they put on a good program. So also, we took part, I was invited to take part in a Mayor's Roundtable for the Urban Land Institute's conference in Oak Brook this past week. And I want to thank them for allowing me to be a part of that. A lot of topics on development in the new age and the new economy. So it was a very nice event, well attended. A lot of my colleagues out there and a lot of those involved in urban land planning throughout the country and throughout the region. Congratulations to Senator Berentino Tarrant on opening of her new office. She had a ribbon cutting just the other day. I want to thank the Will County Governmental League. I was reelected to the Board of Directors and will once again serve as the Legislative Chairman for the Will County Governmental League. Also, Sam's Club will be hosting the rim cutting for the new hiring center tomorrow at 3 o'clock. We will be holding a coffee, I will be holding, I should say, a coffee at Grand Haven, or I should be joining a coffee, I should say, really, on Wednesday at 8 a.m. Also on Wednesday, and for those who are wondering why we have a meeting on Monday instead of Wednesday, I will be receiving formally receiving at a banquet my award for Mayor of the Year from the Illinois State Crime Commission. So a very prestigious honor, and I thank them once again for their designation, but certainly not something that could be accomplished without all the good work of all the people up here, including the staff and all the people that work for us throughout the village. So also, we will have a Rock in the Ville on June 20th at 7 p.m. Which band we got on this one?
American English. American
English. Yeah, I knew you were going to get there. I knew you had it right there. The American Legion Post 52 will be holding their fundraiser right on June 21st at Silver Cross Field. Still Silver Cross? Yeah, it is. Congressman Lipinski will be hosting a senior fair on June 24th at the Recreation Center from 10 to 2. Representative Manley will be holding a town hall meeting on June 25th here at Village Hall beginning at 6. And I will be attending a couple of meetings with National League of Cities on their steering committees for their mid-year meetings. We will be also visiting with several of our, both of our U.S. senators and several of our members of Congress on some of the issues facing our community and the region in the coming week. And also, we will have fireworks once again, July 3rd. So because we have fireworks on July 3rd, and since we don't want to hear the fireworks in the background or hear all the people taking up the parking spaces, the board meeting will be rescheduled to July 2nd. So that's all I have tonight. So, and I hope everybody had a wonderful Father's Day. I spent most of my morning at the zoo. It was quite lovely. Clerk's report. We don't have a clerk report tonight. Citizens committees, commissions, and liaison reports. Trustee McClevitz, Youth Outreach, Green Team, and REMA.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Green Team, just a reminder again that we do have an electronic recycling center, and it is located at 195 Budler Road. The hours are Wednesday evening 6 to 8 and Saturdays 11 to 3. Great place to drop off any electronics you have. As you know, you're not supposed to include those in your normal garbage. Youth Outreach Committee. We have a great group of people, as I said at our last meeting here, and we're always looking for more youth agencies to join. But we've had some great response so far and looking for more people to join. Right now, the Youth Outreach Commission is planning in the early planning stages for this year's Costume Ball fundraiser, and it's a little bit ways off, but put it down on your calendars, Saturday, November 2nd at High Point. A lot of fun. Everyone who has attended the last 2 years has just had a fantastic time. The Commission's next meeting is Monday, September 9th, 6 p.m. at the Recreation Department. And at this time for REMA, what I would like to do is extend my condolences to the family of Rich Fredericks. He has recently passed away. He's been an outstanding member of REMA, and obviously this is a big loss for REMA and a big loss for the village. He's been a lifelong resident of Romeoville. He was a fireman for the village, and he was also heavily involved with the Boy Scouts, so he will be missed, and I do want to send my condolences to his family. And that's all I have.
Very good. Trustee Clancy.
Thank you. As far as beautification commission, or committee, they are out looking for those homes again during the summer. So make sure you have your yard work done, and they'll be announcing the winners later in the summer. And the first Rockin' of the Ville will be June 20th, and it'll be American English, as was stated earlier. This concert is from 7 to 9, and the best, one of the best parts of it, it's free. Also, it's time to get all amped up for a night of sports, so join the Romeoville Recreation Department and the Lockport Township Park District for a night of intense sports activities. Sunday, June 30th, from 4 to 7 at Sunset Park. And guess what? This is another free event. So get out there and be active in your town. Thank you.
Very good. Trustee Griffin. Veterans Commission, RPTV.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
VOR-TV.
The first live outdoor concert is going to be this Thursday with American English that we're going to be showing live. And as a reminder, all the videos can be viewed on Comcast Channel 6, UVerse 99, and on YouTube. And in terms of the Veterans Commission, our next regularly scheduled meeting is Tuesday the 16th at 4 o'clock in the afternoon at the Rec Center. And again, we have a dedicated voicemail line for veterans information. If you just call the village switchboard and ask for it, you'll be transferred to it, and you can be expected to have a returned phone call in 1 or 2 days. And go Hawks. That's it.
Very good. Trustee Chavez.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. No update on the EDC. As mentioned last time, they take the summer break, and they'll be announcing their fall startup meetings to be determined. Police and Fire Commission will update the testing for our new police list will be this Saturday at the Rec Center at 8:45, I believe it is. And I haven't got the latest update, but there's has to be a list. Last I heard, like 300 guys that applied, so that's a good sign. And Chief gave me an update to the candidates that are going for their physical testing. Next Tuesday, two of the current candidates will be going for the physical testing this week. So we're moving forward to get some more police officers on the street for us.
Very good.
That's all I have, Mayor.
I've heard there's a lot of good candidates applying this round.
Absolutely.
So I think we're going to see a pretty good crop.
So. Yeah, I'm hoping so.
Village Manager's Report.
Yes, thank you, Mayor and Board. It's a quick update on downtown. Spartan Square, as you probably have seen, the second half of the old shopping center has been demoed. It's quite a different site looking from Normantown down. You don't see any old Spartan Square shopping center there. So it is down. They're just kind of sorting out the different materials now. The Athletic Event Center, foundations are poured. If you go there, you can kind of see the size of it. You can see the foundation lines. They're moving very swiftly. Dawn was looking at the precast concrete late last week, and so we're moving along fairly quickly. So it's going well. That's all I have.
Very good. New business. First, we have Ordinance 131047, ordinance approving and authorizing execution of an amendment to the Plains River Valley Enterprise Zone Intergovernmental Agreement.
Make a motion.
Motion approved by Trustee Chavez.
Second.
Second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Palmer?
Aye.
I'm sorry, Trustee Clancy?
That's what I thought you were
doing. Trustee McClevin?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Next, we have Ordinance 131048, ordinance amending the designating ordinance of the Village of Romeoville in connection with the Des Plaines River Valley Enterprise Zone.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Clancy.
Second.
Second by Trustee McClevitz. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Next, we have Resolution 131676, resolution waiving the bids and awarding a contract to Lumina Inc. for July 3rd and Romeo Fest fireworks displays.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Griffin.
Second.
Second by Trustee Chavez. Any further discussion? Hearing none. Can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee McClevitz?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Next, we have Resolution 131677, a resolution to waive the bid process and enter into a contract with Wick Building Systems, Inc. for the purchase of 151 by 112 steel-sided building.
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Chavez.
Second.
Second by Trustee Griffin. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee McLevitz?
Aye.
Motion carried.
Board comments. Trustee Chavez, please.
Yes, thank you, Mayor. I also would like to give my condolences to the Rick Frederick's family. You know, I've attended his fundraiser for him, and he looked good then, you know, obviously fighting cancer and all that. He's going to be missed. He was a great man. He was my son's, my twins were little. He was the pack leader, and he did a great job. And I have a lot of great memories with that man. He did a great thing, great service to the community, as everybody knows, working for REMA, worked for the fire department, and he did so much for the youth. And he'd definitely be missed. And I just want to, in closing, say that obviously summer's here now. Kids are out running around, so just be careful. And once again, if you can get your kids involved in some programs, please do so. There's so much to be offered at our rec center for the kids, private organizations like soccer leagues, football leagues, baseball leagues, travel leagues. I can't urge enough to get your kids involved, keep them off the streets, keep them busy. They'll grow up to be better people. That's all I have, Mayor.
Very good. Trustee Griffin, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I want to congratulate our mayor on this singular honor that the Illinois Crime Commission is going to be bestowing on Wednesday night. Well deserved, and congratulations. And all I've got is American English is a really terrific band. For those of you who haven't seen it, come on out. They put on a super show, and obviously the price is right, and go Hawks.
Very good.
That's it.
They do put on a great show. Trustee Clancy.
Okay, first of all, I'd like to thank everyone that did show up for the car show. It was tremendous the way it worked out. We had tremendous weather after all. It was supposed to rain that day, or they predicted rain. And I actually believe there was a few cars that got there a little late because of travel time. But maybe they'll make it next year. And people were asking how often are we going to have them. So that might go into the plans of, you never know, we might expand the shows. Okay, and summer is here, like was mentioned earlier, so watch out for the children that are in the streets, and maybe sign them up for some of that special care at the rec center as far as the Sunday camp. And as far as congratulations to the mayor, tremendous job, and that'll be coming up this Wednesday. And as far as rocking the Ville, American English, what more can you say? And we get to see them free out here. They play on a regular basis in venues that actually charge you to see them, but we get them out here for free for the people of Romeoville. And to the Fredericks family, we're definitely going to miss Rich. He's been around for years and years, not only with the Boy Scouts, the Cub Scouts, the Fire Department, ESDA, helping his neighbors out when they needed, you know, things fixed and repaired around the house. Tremendous man, and we definitely will miss him. Thank you.
Yes, again, Fredericks family, again, they just... Again, it's always tough to lose somebody that's been a part of the community, so we definitely want them to know that we're thinking about them. Trustee McLevitz, please.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. First, I'd like to congratulate the fire department. I believe they have receiving an excellent ISO rating, from what I understand. So congratulations. I know it's not easy to do. From what I understand, it's better than the majority of fire departments throughout the country or whatnot. So. Very good. Good job on that. And then congratulations. As I understand, one of our new police recruits graduated valedictorian of her class, if I read that correctly. And it's a good thing I wasn't a teacher, because I certainly struggle with saying names, but I'm going to guess on this one. The first name, Melinda, okay, but Schlayback, perhaps? All right. Well,
good way to put it, Keith.
Very diplomatic.
We'll say Melinda C. So congratulations, valedictorian of her class, and she's somebody who's going to be with us, part of the team here in Romeoville. So a couple fantastic things happening in our fire and police. June 25th, there is our next park party at Rotary Park on Whitmore Drive. That's 6 o'clock to 8 o'clock. Just a reminder again, obviously it's summer season, so that means road construction season, and there's a lot of it going on here in town. We've got Taylor Road, Weber Road, and now in the new Uptown Square area, I believe Phelps and Town Hall Drive have some various things that are affecting them as well. So more information on the website. If you want to find out a little bit more about that, make sure to go to www.romeoville.org to find more about the construction. And congratulations also to the mayor for your Mayor of the Year award. And that's all I have. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We have executive session. No, okay. Quick one, but no announcement. Land purchase. Motion to go into executive session?
So moved.
Motion by Trustee Clancy, second by Trustee Chavez. Any further discussion? Hearing none, can I get a roll call, please?
Trustee Clancy?
Aye.
Trustee Chavez?
Aye.
Trustee McLevitt?
Aye.
Trustee Griffin?
Aye.
Motion carried.